Thanks for joining me once again on TCPIP Basics, and this time we're going to talk about packet fragmentation. Here's a graphic of what a packet could look like. We see a header with 20 bytes, and we see a data packet with 10,000 bytes. Now, we could end up having that data get broken up into four different packet-sized fragments. So how and why does this happen? Well, if you try to push a 2-inch wide dowel into a 1-inch hole, what's going to happen? Well, you're going to see something break. Either the material around the hole is going to break or the dowel itself. And this is the problem that we have with IP fragmentation. Too much data through a pipe, not big enough to handle it using TCPIP. IP fragmentation is an internet protocol process that breaks packets into smaller pieces, which we call fragments, so that the resulting pieces can pass through a link with a smaller maximum transmission unit than the original packet size. We refer to these as MTUs. This can cause a slowdown in receiving a data packet, and it can also cause errors if the packet is reassembled incorrectly, causing it to have to be resent using TCP. How do we know if a packet's going to be fragmented when it leaves our computer? Well, when we send a packet, we have no idea what the other side is capable of as far as MTU size. We send the packet and hope for the best, unless, of course, we have control over the device that we're sending data to, where we can make a change to the MTU if necessary. So when will the packet fragment? Well, since the sender has no idea about what's on the other side, unless they have control over the device, the packet won't fragment until it gets to the router or computer at the destination. The router may fragment the packet if the router receive size is too small, or the receiving computer may fragment the packet for the same reason. So why are these packets fragmented? Well, some manufacturers make their receive size packets smaller for several reasons. One could be speed. It may not support over a certain size. Another could be security. By limiting packet size, you can allow a device like a router to slow down the traffic to make sure the buffers don't get overflowed when an attack happens. A third may be physical limitations of the device manufacturer. I would typically see fragmentation when sending between two manufacturer devices or two different operating systems that came up with the best packet size only for their operating system, and they didn't consider other operating systems that were going to send data to them. If the hardware is capable of it, you can use the operating system's network card properties to make the packet size of the MTU larger or smaller, and then you can review the results when the data is sent back and forth between the computers. Sometimes it takes some tweaking, but eventually you will find the right size. Let's talk about message transfer units. Now, in a Windows computer, the default size is 1500 bytes. So where do we get that? Well, it's 1500 bytes, but then we have to subtract some things. We end up subtracting 20 for the IP header and another 8 bytes for the ICMP header. That leaves us with 1,472 usable bytes. Anything larger than 1,500 bytes and you're going to see fragmentation happen. And that's going to possibly slow down the network or cause some of these errors. You can adjust the MTU size by going into the device manager and editing the device properties if the device allows it. And most network cards do allow that. Sending MTUs can cause a slowdown or help speed up a network after the receiving side MTU is known.